So it was asked of me quite a while ago now, by one of my viewers, to show some of the cordless lithium power tools that I have. So I have amassed the big stuff all in one spot here, and not all of these are lithium, but these are the cordless electric operated tools that I use on a regular basis. Pretty much everything I own now is electric, in terms of pretty much everything I own. The only thing that really isn't electric, well, I still have my old snow blower, which is a two-stroke gas, which I don't use anymore. Been meaning to give that to my parents. My dad refuses to go fully electric, or he gave in a bit and went with an electric weed whacker just because he was always tired of those damn things not starting ever. Ever since California got their hands on the stupid CARB rules, and well, those tiny little engines, just unless you spend, $400 on a steel or something, they just don't last. So, well, snowblower is one. The other is my riding lawn tractor. Yes, this bronchitis still has not gone away. So, riding lawn tractor, just, I don't have a huge yard, but I also don't have the most time in the world to cut it. So I can do it in 22 minutes with a lawn tractor, or with a push mower will take me approximately 3 hours, just due to the hilly nature and things getting in the way. Anyways, I am counting the days till the motor blows on the garden tractor so I can replace it with a electric motor. So there, and considering that the garden tractor only burns about a gallon of fuel a summer, I kind of modified the gearbox and put a different one in there, so it goes almost about 40% faster than it did originally. Figured it's out of warranty, who cares anymore? And I mean, it's not like, it's grass. I mean, it's not like I'm cutting through thick bushes, so it does just fine. Anyways, back to the real purpose of the video. The tools I use on a regular basis, and I stress regular. Basically, I have one, two, three main brands here. Most of them are either going to be Works brand, Craftsman, Sears Craftsman, or Snow Joe slash Sun Joe, same company. They differentiate summer tools or versus winter only tools by either calling them Snow Joe or Sun Joe. And I also have a few tools, a few things, Hoover for my vacuum, and Zip Snip for a rotary cardboard cutter. I work from home. Half my income's YouTube, the other half is selling motorcycle parts and now hoverboard scooters online and on Craigslist and to other dealers around Wisconsin. And because of that, I get lots of cardboard boxes. A shipment I'll usually net. I already recycled most of them. I usually put them out for Craigslist and as free moving boxes, strong stuff, but cutting apart double walled super heavy duty boxes that were containing 150 pounds of motorcycle scooter parts gets a little tiring after about the first, I don't know, one. So that Zip Snip really comes in handy, and I got it on sale like $10, and it's got a single 18650 lithium cell in it. So why don't we start with the tools that I don't have too many of. So let's start with the Zip Snip. That's the little mugger right there. It's got a rotating stainless steel blade, which is now slightly dull from cutting through staples and, staples. There you go. Works great. It can usually do about 40 boxes on a single charge, but towards the end I got to start going slower, as otherwise, you know, it starts stalling out and low voltage cutoff then. So if I go slow, I can usually make it through about 40 boxes on a charge. And don't really know how long it takes to charge. I just plug it in before bed and it's done in the morning. Next, well, either way, the zip snip and tools that are pretty much identical, just different names, work absolutely amazing for cardboard. No, that is not a gallon. That's not a tank of gas. It's actually waste motor oil. I find ways to recycle it all and reuse it. I don't take it to the recycle center. It's my waste motor oil. Next, I have a Hoover lithium ion vacuum. Let's see if we can. I can't zoom in on it. This thing is powerful. And as you can see by the black duct tape and paint stick holding the handle on, my little Vinny got his hands on it and decided to throw it down the stairs. Understandable. He's allowed to get away with things. And that was 2 years ago, and it still works. Original battery. Battery charges in about 2 hours, and I can get a good solid 20 minutes of vacuuming out of it. I mean, it's not a long time for vacuuming, but I mean, if you're someone who vacuums once a month, this vacuum is not for you. I mean, if you touch up once a week or a couple times a week, I usually vacuum once a week and then just touch up the kids' spills. I spilled my cookies and I got crumbs everywhere. You know, it's easy to just touch up, and it is powerful. It picks up, it really is comparable to a standard plug-in vacuum. Pretty good. And the battery's got, I think, 5 18650 cells in there. If you notice, I take just about everything apart at some point. Next, my push lawnmower. Oh, this is a good one. It was, at one point, many, many moons ago, a Toro plug-in electric. Not anymore. Now it's cordless. And uses a light switch as an on-off switch. Safe? Not at all. On the bright side is, since it's a 15-amp switch, if I stall the motor out, which has happened once or twice, the light switch just happens to kind of melt and just kind of powers down. I do have a safety switch that needs to go on there. I put that on there because I kind of lost the safety key on my last safety switch. So, yeah. The only thing I really used this one for is cutting the grass around the train tracks around the backyard. I had built a 7.5-inch gauge narrow gauge railway in the backyard. We can actually ride on it. If you dig through some of my YouTube videos, you can see us taking the locomotive to Train Mountain in Chililoquin, if I'm pronouncing it right. Oregon, or basically Crater Lake, Kismet Falls. That is also lead acid powered. Now, what's running the lawnmower, and to cut the grass on the around the tracks, basically the track fits perfectly under the deck. The blade height, I kind of shaved the bolts a little bit. Now the blade height will be about a half inch above the track, which is great for getting the grass around the sides. And then after I do one pass with that, then I can just go with the weed whacker and clean everything up. one, two, three, piece of cake. I do that maybe once a month is all I need on that. But it is using a Bosch car starter as the motor. But since it's not actually turning an engine, you know, a high compression engine, it's basically just free spinning a blade. The amperage draw is like 3 amps. It's next to nothing. And since it's 12 volt, I just use a 12 volt car battery, which that battery is like 13 years old now. And I really neglect it. I mean, shoot, I just leave that thing sit outside under my deck all winter. Don't charge it, and it still holds a perfect charge. The only reason it's inside right now is because I brought it in to show you all, which I might as well, as long as I got it in here, yeah, I might as well top the battery off. It's probably full anyways. So that covers the single-use items against the back wall in that top box. There is actually a 12 volt nickel cadmium grease gun. I bring that up to the railroad I volunteer at during the summer, grease all the turntables. I mean, I can go do half a tube of grease per side of the turntable on the wheels. That's how much grease those suckers take. We got to do it yearly, get all the water out that kind of pools in there over the winter while the railroad's closed. And man, doing that by hand will take an hour. Doing it with that thing takes about 5 minutes and one drain battery per side. I've had that forever. Don't know how the batteries are still holding up after this much time, but oof. That was a Harbor Freight one. So let's carry on to the more tool-y tools. Let's move over to the craftsman stuff. Now, I used to have a motorcycle shop, which I had closed down when I got separated, and I'm now a single father of two kids, one disabled, so I couldn't run a motorcycle shop full-time while at the same time taking care of my boys. So, that's now. In the past, I needed tools, basically drills. I wanted a high-quality drill that would last and was lightweight so I could get in to undo screws and undo nuts and bolts with sockets on the ends. And I needed it to a good battery life, too. So I saw some good reviews on the Nextech 12-volt lithium-powered. And I got these when they first came out, at least the first one. The one on top was the first generation drill and screw gun. The one on the bottom was the second generation version. I think they discontinued the second and they went back to the first. I originally just bought the one. It was about an hour and a half, 2 hours to recharge the battery originally. And then they came out with something basically like a Tesla supercharger. If the battery was below 25% state of charge, and you put it on this new style charger, the button would glow orange. You hit the orange button, and basically it would give it a good 50% charge in 2 minutes, and then resort back to standard charging so as not to overheat the battery. Don't recommend doing that on hot days, but as long as it's kept cool, you know, so you don't reduce the life of the battery at all. But the reason I got the second one then was because just due to the excessive use, I'd have the screwdriver attachment, then I'd take that off, put on a wire brush wheel, take that off, drill 20 holes in quarter-inch steel for a conversion electric car I was building. And then that, I think that was what pushed that one over the edge. Anyways, I wore out the chuck on the original one that I had, the first gen. So then I went and I saw, oh, second gen's got a few more inch pounds torque, a little bit higher RPM. So I went with that one. And so now I kind of jury-rigged it, so now the chuck is pretty much permanently closed in the old one, so I just leave the screw attachment on that one, and then I use the second one for, because it's also, you know, a more beefy one, I use that for the sockets, so I leave the socket attachment, since that's what I use the most on that one, so I leave the little socket attachment on the end, and since the chuck works on that, if I need, I'll switch over to a wire brush wheel or a drill bit on that one. The nice thing is the batteries are interchangeable. And that moves us on to that one, which is actually an auto hammer. Why I bought that, I have no idea. Thinking back, just about everybody uses screws in this modern age. I've actually only used that, I think, twice, and that was where I was trying to remove an axle from a rusted to hell axle on a front wheel of a motorcycle, and I had to do it without damaging the axle since I could not get a replacement. It was a vintage classic bike, and so I couldn't damage it by smacking on it with a sledgehammer. So I used, the only time I've ever used that is I put that on the end, and since it was such a mild impact, but a lot of impacts, it took about 20 minutes and two batteries, but I was able to very slowly tap it through. Yes, I used PB Blaster, or P Blaster, whatever that penetrating oil is, soaked it for about 2 weeks every day, twice or two or three times a day I'd spray it, and still took that much with that thing. At least I didn't damage anything. I would not have been able to replace that axle, at least not easily. I'd probably have to go to my lathe and make, you know, turn my own. Not fun. But once again, universal battery. Set use the same battery as the drills. Next is the oscillating multi-tool. I also have a plug-in version. Plugs into your 120 outlet. Plug-in version, of course, works a little better. It's a lot smoother and doesn't vibrate the crap out of your hands. This one, the cordless one, does vibrate the crap out of your hands, but at the same time, the multi-tool works great. The only downside to them is those blades do not last on them. I mean, cutting aluminum, I'd go through a blade like you can't believe, but for the few jobs you need them for, they do work absolutely awesome. And once again, uses the same batteries as the two drills and the auto hammer. And, of course, got the Tesla. Why not get a vacuum to vacuum it out? And this little shop vac comes in really handy. Only lasts about 5 minutes on a battery charge. And it's not the most powerful, but if you put that more restrictive nozzle on there, I mean, it does a great job of vacuuming out a car. All you need is one battery worth and vacuum out. I can vacuum out the entire car, get all the Cheerios and all the other stuff the kids throw in there out. It's also great around the house. Vacuum the stairs. Lightweight, portable. Clean up around the fireplace. While it wasn't powerful, the price was right. Since they discontinued it, $20, good to go. And once again, uses the same battery as those. Ooh, I just sold something on eBay. Sold my last P3 kilowatt meter. I got about 100 of them coming in yet. Those kilowatt meters are neat. Got them at a good price. I'm selling them for $15 a pop if anybody's interested. Next, let's move on to the chainsaw. No, snowblower. This is a Snowjo snowblower. Original price was actually about $4.99. It was then marked down to 397. Whoopsie doodle. It was then marked down to 397, and because nobody was buying it, they ended up, because this was the display model at Walmart, they ended up knocking it down to $100 even. Not a bad deal, if I might say so myself, because Snow Joe sells the batteries for like a, just the battery alone for like $150. That is a 40-volt, 18-inch single-stage snow thrower. I've actually not gotten to use it yet, because I got it at the end of last snow season, right as spring was in the air. Every time I look, sorry, that's probably copyright. I'll probably get busted by YouTube for singing that. So I got that, and basically, it's got this neat little headlight on there. So basically what I did is, just to make sure the battery was good, because it was still brand new and it still came with the factory warranty, I fully charged the battery, and then I used, made sure all the functions worked. It has a little switch to turn the chute, so no turning it by hand. Actually, the sucker actually works like as a leaf blower too, not officially, but once the auger starts turning at such high speed, basically it just sucked up the leaves and shot them out the chute. Not that it really accomplished anything because they just kind of randomly flew out, but it's kind of fun. So tested it all, then I used the light to drain the battery pack down to about 50% for the summer storage. Well, I have a plug-in, old Black & Decker plug-in chainsaw, and I kind of burned it up this summer cutting some firewood for the winter. The oiler stopped working, bearings went out, and blah, blah, blah. I've since fixed it using junk parts I had laying around, which is kind of cool. Because now I got a backup, and it works, but it works like crap, but it still works. So anyways, I thought, gosh, you know what? 150 feet of extension cord really sucks. I'd like to just go lithium. Well, since I had so many tools of them, I tried getting a lithium chainsaw by Works. Well, Works did not have one at the time, because I wanted one that would match the universal batteries of my Works tools. So I thought, well, hey, I got a Snow Joe snowblower. I wonder if Snow Joe's got a chainsaw. Well, sure as shnit, they do. So I got the Sun Joe 16-inch chainsaw. Now, this thing is impressive. I can cut about, well, I got a review video on it, but I can cut about a half cord of wood on a single charge while the battery is nice fresh off the charger. In fact, I generally overheat the battery before the battery's actually dead. So when I do that, it's got the automatic thermal cutout, which is nice. And that uses the same 40-volt battery that the snowblower does, which is great, because when I'm cutting firewood, basically I drain one battery. When that battery's drained, I shove it on the charger. Then I put battery number two in, start cutting again. By the time battery number two is drained, battery number one's got about a 50% charge, and use that up. And by that point, I am done, and I'm calling it a day. I can usually get about 40 to 50 minutes of cut time on a charge, which ain't bad. And a nice sharp, and I stress sharp chain, a dull chain. You'll be sitting there forever, and that sucker's going to drain so fast. So I highly endorse that chainsaw. It is awesome, and it is lightweight without the battery. It's 6 pounds with the battery. It's about 8. Very easy to use, and for safety, all you got to do is pull the battery out, and the thing's going to be completely inert. So, and since no gas, I toss it in the trunk of the Tesla. And if I see a nice log someone's given away and they're on the end of their driveway. I can go there, cut it up into nice pieces, and I got, you know, a week's worth of firewood all at one crack. Ain't that nice? Let's move on to the bulk, the big brute force tools. My works lawn tools, of which, as of yesterday, I now have four. Originally, my mom, well, I originally got this neat cordless nickel cadmium powered weed trimmer from Aldi's. The price, including two batteries and the charger, a 30-minute charger, I might add, was $39.99. Got that about 2006. It worked and still works awesome. The problem I had, and I kept and maintained the batteries, and they were still good up until a year ago, is I burned up the charger. I dropped it off my workbench by accident, and apparently that was enough to loosen something up, so I plugged it in, put a battery on there, hit the charge button, and spark, spark, and that sucker was done. Unfortunately, I cannot and could not find a replacement for it, and Aldi/Kingcraft does not carry any replacements. So until I mod that one to use, I'll probably make a custom battery pack for it using 18650 cells. I got a ton of them. That's just going to be hanging up there, not like it's going to wear out sitting on my shelf. So, because of that, my ma kept her eye open. And at the end of a summer of 2013, she found at Walmart these on sale. It was in a dual package. You got the leaf blower and the weed trimmer. And I think original price was like $180. She ended up getting the package for $40, and that included both of those plus a battery and charger. Awesome. And that was what got me started into the lithium garden tools, snowblower, and chainsaw, and just the amount of... I never thought that the power of a lithium battery would run garden tools like this for as long as they do. I get about 15, 20 minutes out of the leaf blower. I get a lot of trim time out of the weed whacker on a single charge. 1.5 battery charges is enough to completely trim my yard. So that was 2014 summer, was the summer I got to use those two. And then this summer, one of my neighbors brought to my attention that my hedges are starting to get a little out of control. So, I tried one of my parents had a 120 volt hedge trimmer, so I used that, and I ended up slicing through an extension cord, and that was entertaining with the sparks. And then of course the circuit breaker tripped. I was done. I mean, hedge trimmer is something that I'm not the only person that's done that. My neighbor did that with their electric corded one. My dad's done it. And of course, my dad's always stealing my extension cords because I keep mine in good, usable condition. So I thought, what the heck? Let's see. Does Works have a hedge trimmer? So I found the hedge trimmer by Works. And my timing, you know, I'm never in a rush for things. Timing was great. Got it. It was a little it was on sale, but it was still a little pricier than I wanted to spend. I could have got just the core tool. Core tool meaning you get the tool minus a battery and charger for someone like me that already has a battery and charger. But then they had a special on the tool with another battery and charger. It was only like 15, 20 bucks more than the core tool. So I'm like, cool, yeah, I'll do that. Now I got two batteries. And man, what a difference that makes. Now I can do my trimming, use a little bit of the second battery for finishing up the trimming, and then go at it with the blower. And, I mean, very convenient. Well, I've seen these jaw saw cutters. I like the fireplace. I use a lot of firewood. All pre-dead stuff. I don't go cutting down trees. I go and I take trees that are already down, and that's what I use. I like a good, nice, relaxing fire, nice, good, warm heat, and kids do too. Lay down in front of it with a blanket and read them some bedtime stories, knocks them right out. So, like I said before, Works did not have a lithium chainsaw at the time, so that's why I went with Snow Joe. And I'm glad I did. It was perfect, and it's very well built. Well, I've been seeing these jaw saws all over the place, and basically you put it over a smaller, about 4 or 5 inch log or smaller, and you just press down, the chainsaw bar comes down, slices it off, and you are good to go. And it uses the same battery, 20-volt battery, as my other Works tools. I've been watching them for a while, and the plug-in version was $99 all over the place, including the hardware store. And the battery version was about $189.99. So I've been watching it. Well, Black Friday came. I did some major coupon stacking. And it had the core tool only instead of base price instead of $190, which would have been the price for even on Black Friday for the other one before coupon stacking, was $100. So I did my coupon stacking, all said and done, including the cash back that I got through Fat Wallet. It was the Ebates. I can't remember. Whatever, I just took whatever cash back I could get. I ended up getting jaw saw for $50. And that just arrived yesterday. I know it's been a little while. They used FedEx Smart Post, which, depending on what the customer's buying, not always the best idea. But it was free shipping, and I got it dirt cheap, not going to complain too much. So I have yet to try the jaw saw. Since it just arrived yesterday, you haven't had time. But once again, core tool, I figure two batteries is enough for the time being for the Works tools. The chargers are pretty quick on the Works tools. It's about an hour for a full charge, roughly an hour for a full recharge for the Works tools. That's plenty for me. I plan on giving the jaw saw a try this weekend. I have about 3 cords of wood on my back patio, and some of it's a little long. I was going to go at it with the chainsaw and start, snipping them up into more manageable pieces. I only have a small fireplace insert. Before I put that insert in, my fireplace was huge, but not very efficient. So I got one of those inserts, and it's a gasifying insert. And now I can pretty much heat the whole house. It's got a nice blower on there. I could go through a cord of wood in 1 week before in my old fireplace and have very little to show for it. Now I toss one 6-inch log in my fireplace insert, and that's enough wood to heat my house overnight and keep it at the house at about 70 degrees when it's 32 degrees outside or freezing outside. So hopefully that jaw saw lives up to its expectation, its advertising hype. The YouTube videos I watched on it look pretty promising. If not, the price I paid for it, I'll just put it up for sale. But I like having a nice little arsenal of tools like this. Just wish I had more space to put everything. Let's see. What else might I have? Well, I got an 18650 powered flashlight. That's 1,000 lumens. That's what I carry with me. I have a solar powered table lamp in my office that's in front of my window, which is kind of nice. That's about 400 lumens, maybe 350. Now, it used to use three rechargeable AAA nickel metal hydride batteries, but the voltages for that ended up being roughly the same as an 18650. So I used a old laptop 18650 cell, put that in there with a little protection circuit, and now it charges considerably better, and it lasts, shoot, I could leave it on all night and it'll still be on in the morning. Which is really kind of cool. It's convenient since I'm on time of use electric. Instead of having all my lights on in my office, which, I mean, really glares my computer screen, sometimes you just need that little side glow just as a ambient light, and works perfect for that. Let's see. Well, I sell the hoverboard scooters now. So I got a lithium-powered hoverboard scooter as a demo unit, and I'm also going to be making some cool videos on that, as it can legally be used as a handicap mobility device. And my son is handicapped, so I made some stroller modifications that now incorporate a hoverboard scooter. So I shrunk down his tiny little handicap tags and put them on the scooter, and now we can zip around. And it makes life so much easier when road tripping in a Tesla. Pull up in a supercharger, plug in, and we just pull out the hoverboard, a modified stroller, and we can zip on down the road to a restaurant or store, you know, something to do while the car is getting juiced up. Let's see, other duals. Basically, all my nickel-cadmium stuff is now pretty much junk. All those cells, I really somehow managed to squeeze a good 15 years out of those nickel cadmium cells, but I came up with a little charging and discharge ritual, discharge and charging ritual, and that's what really gave those a long life. And every once in a while I zapped them with 240 volts to break down the quote-unquote whiskers that develop inside nickel-cadmium cells to and end up internally shorting them out by applying a very high voltage, AC or DC, and I mean you just quickly tap it across, basically fries those little quote-unquote whiskers that grow inside the cells, restoring your capacity back, or at least a good small portion of it. What am I forgetting? Well, I guess other tools. I have my two camcorders. Those are lithium-powered. You're looking through the lens of my 4K one now. My other one's on my charger. I use the other one more often for charging the batteries because my 4K is pretty much taken over. Soon I'll have a Tesla Powerwall in here. Don't know where the heck I'm going to put it. But Tesla's given me a free Powerwall due to all the referrals I got. And, of course, my car is electric, both of them. My old Alfa Romeo, which it's pitch black outside, so I'm not even going to go out there to try and show you. But my Alfa Romeo was the last conversion. I've done 26 conversions. That was the last conversion I did in my daily commuter and driver, which was then replaced by the Tesla. And the Alpha is now for sale. That one is lead-acid powered. Not recommended. You could take it on the freeway, but it'll drain those batteries too quick. More of a round-town car. I did 19 miles a day in it, just from home to work, work to home. That's all I needed it for. Cost me 15 cents round trip. It would have cost a buck at the time with the gas prices. It would have cost like a buck 30 to a buck 75 in my old Econo box, which was a Nissan Q. And it would have cost about $350 in my truck. Yeah. I got, of course, tons of 120 volt tools, but those aren't too special. I guess that's it. I'm going to call it. I think I'm going to toss tonight's log in the fireplace. This one should burn until, what time is it? 10:20 p.m. If I toss it in at 10:30, that'll burn until about 7 when Vinny gets up. And then I can toss another one in. I'm good to go until probably afternoon. I go through about 3 of those logs a day. Keeps the house at 70 plus degrees, so comfortable. I do have a Power Wheels Corvette that I picked up at Goodwill store for $14. Modified it a bit. Instead of 6 volt, it is now 12 volt. And I'm going to I make solar panels from scratch. Well, not scratch. I get the cells and I make custom ones to whatever I want to do. So I'm going to put a solar canopy on that over the winter so that my boys will be able to drive down the street in style in a solar-powered Power Wheels. But I am also repainting it and putting a Tesla logo on it. Forget Corvette. Come on. Tesla should have their own Power Wheels by now. I don't know why. Of course, the electric car doesn't have an electric Power Wheels. Yet, the gas guzzler sports car have Power Wheels. Go figure. What a rip. That's it. So, have a good night, everybody. I think I'm going to bed early. Why is the video not stopping? Come on.